Donald Trump's tax returns. The New York Times spotlights the role The Apprentice played in shoring up his finances. President Trump's tax records show that starting in 2005, the reality TV series provided new stream of cash for a business that was suffering heavy losses. According to the Times, Mr. Trump's genius, it turned out, wasn't running a company. It was making himself famous. Trump scale famous and monetizing that fame. And while the returns showed that he earned some $197 million directly from The Apprentice over 16 years, roughly in line with what he has claimed, they also reveal that an additional $230 million flowed from the fame associated with it. Trump parlayed the show's big ratings into sponsorship deals for Domino's Pizza and laundry detergent, among others. The Times writes, there were seven-figure licensing deals with hotel builders, some with murky backgrounds in former Soviet republics and other developing countries. And there were schemes that exploited misplaced trust in the TV version of Mr. Trump, who off-camera peddled worthless get-rich-quick seminars. Success from The Apprentice led to taxable income for the president for the first time in years. He made so much that over 3 years he paid a total of $70.1 million in income taxes, later refunded with interest via an aggressive accounting maneuver now under audit. The Times writes, all right. Willie?
Well, it's all in the documents. It's not from the New York Times. It's from the IRS. Let's bring in former Treasury official, Morning Joe economic analyst, Steve Rattner. Steve, I know you have some charts that you're going to walk us through, but first, big picture here. This is sort of what businessmen like you and businessmen we all know around New York have been saying for 40-some years, that Donald Trump's not actually a businessman, that he's a guy who licenses his name to steaks and vodka and buildings and mattresses and anything else willing to put his name on it. What is this latest New York Times piece just posting overnight? What does it tell you?
I think it illustrates the point that was being made a minute ago, that Donald Trump is not so much a businessman, a guy who operates businesses and runs businesses, but a guy who promotes himself and makes his money off of his name, his image, his personality, and so forth. And of course, the fact that he went bankrupt multiple times in the 90s helps you understand what a bad businessman he is. But in fact, as Mika was just alluding to, the vast preponderance, and we have a chart on this that we can put up if you want, the vast preponderance of the income that Trump has been making has all been from these kinds of licensing deals, from The Apprentice, from licensing stuff not just to Domino's Pizza, but even to things like Double Oreos, and then also from some investments he had with third parties in which he derived income, but not from anything he was doing, but really from the efforts of these other people. And so when you add them all up, you can see that there's about $600 million or more that he earned from these sources. But meanwhile, from his own business, from businesses he actually ran, he was losing $175 million. So in fact, Donald Trump, the great businessman, the guy who was going to run America like he ran a business, I hope not, turns out to have been a pretty bad businessman after all. And now, as you say, he's facing $400 million of personal loans that are coming due shortly. He potentially owes the IRS another $100 million. We may find out that Donald Trump isn't a billionaire at all.
Documents also show that he's actually not failed colossally once. He's done it twice. He got $400 million in the equivalent of today's money from his father. He blew that. His businesses went bankrupt. He just completely collapsed financially in the early 90s. And then as he struggled through the 90s and into the first part of the new century, he was so desperate that, as the New York Times said, an endorsement for a big and tasty burger was one of the few bright spots in his financial situation until The Apprentice came along. The Apprentice came along. He made about $400 million, another $400 million, and he blew that too by making stupid investments in golf courses and other places across the world that have been bleeding him of his money for the past decade.
Donald Trump is like nine parts ego and one part businessman. And so it's boom and bust. The boom is when he gets money from his father, and then he goes bust. Then he has another boom when he markets himself and his ego and gets a lot of money from a television show. And then he goes with his ego to get golf courses because he loves golf and sees himself as this big golfer. And then those are all going bust. It is interesting, but I actually think one of the most powerful things in all these documents in terms of the voters and elections is the fact that he paid more in taxes to the Philippines and to Panama and to Turkey than he did to the United States of America. In 2016, the year that this country said he's our guy, he paid $750 and he paid over $300,000 to other countries. So America first, not so much.
That's just remarkable. And you look at the money that he's gotten from the other countries. And again, the question is, you know, does another country actually control the debt that Donald Trump has to pay back? Or is it a bank? Is it a U.S. institution? Hard to say, but I know around the time of the election, the top banks in New York, at least, were saying that they wouldn't loan Donald Trump a dime. But Claire makes a great point, John Meacham, that here's a guy that, again, continues to stiff the U.S. government. And again, tax avoidance is one thing. If you do it legally, that's the problem of the United States Congress and a tax code that favors, unfortunately, the billionaires that can do this. But this looks like tax evasion. And Donald Trump, more importantly, looks like a snake oil salesman. And while the United States of America across 240 years have had quite a few famous snake oil salesmen, none of them ever landed in the White House.